Right now, it brings me great pleasure. Thank you, Lord, to introduce and to present to some. Thank you, Lord, and to present to others a great man of God who, hallelujah, I have deep respect for. He and his wife, they recruited me. Amen. Thank you, Lord, to come back to the PCAF. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, the greatest recruitment ever. I'm talking about on my part, though. On my part. For me. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And I thank God. I truly do. I thank God for Christian Ministries and the Apostolic Faith Church. Amen. And all of your labor of love. I know I just, we had the board of directors speak, but I truly hope that they spoke for each and every one of you that are here today. And I tell you often, and I mean it with all my heart, that I appreciate all your labor of love and the things that you do here at Christian Ministries. Amen? For the kingdom, for the body of Christ. So this great man of God hails all the way from Rochester, New York. Amen. He was the council chairman of the 19th State Council. And the Lord elevated him to the jurisdictional bishop, amen, of the PCAF. Thank you, Lord. And let us receive the man of the hour, amen, in the person of Ronald, Bishop Ronald Mathis. Let's receive him with a hearty amen.
Praise the Lord. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We do want to acknowledge Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. If you haven't, say amen.
Amen.
If you would like, you can stand at this time for the reading of the Word of God. Amen. The scripture lets us know. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And then we'd like for you to, if you have that, Acts chapter number 2. Amen. The Apostolic Church. Amen. Constitution. Amen. If you have it, say amen. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gave them utterance. Please, at this time, would you turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, neighbor, breathe again. Turn to your neighbor one more time and say, breathe again. And please be seated in the presence of the Lord. He has an eternal purpose. Amen. The Bible lets us know that from everlasting to everlasting thou art God. Thou turnest man into destruction and says, return ye children of men. It is God who gives gifts to us while in his eternal state. In fact, he does it even before we are born. It is not a strange thing to know that Pastor Quinn is the pastor of Christian Ministries, Apostolic Faith Churches, because, amen, God, amen, is a God, amen, that speaks from eternity. And he speaks a word, and that word has to be fulfilled in that individual's life. The Bible says that they were on one accord and in one place. Oh, would to God that everyone here, amen, understood that God has created you for a purpose and God has a destiny in mind. Amen. And the two, amen, the two twin towers after prayer is praise and worship. Oh, I wish somebody would give God some glory. The Bible declares that everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. Amen. When you begin to praise God, amen, there's something that begins to run down on the inside of you. When you begin to magnify the Lord, amen, you begin to expand your abdomen. When you begin to praise the Lord, your breathing begins to increase. The breathing cycle increases. When you begin to praise the Lord, amen, the circulatory system, amen, allows the blood to flow. Amen, the adrenaline increases. Amen, amen, the blood circulates through my body. Amen, and because it's so active, I can't sit where I'm sitting. I gotta stand up on my feet. I gotta wave my hand. I gotta praise the Lord. I gotta do a dance. Amen, because there's something down on the inside moving all around me. Yes, I can feel them in my hand. Yes, I can feel them in my feet. But I feel them right now. He's all over me, and he's keeping me alive.
Oh, you ought to praise him right now. You ought to give him a praise. You ought to give him a praise.
Amen. Without praising God, fire can't come. Amen. Because every time you open up your mouth to praise the Lord, amen, the fire of God's presence that should be down on the inside, in your belly, in your innermost being, ought to be stirred up. Amen. I can imagine on the day of Pentecost when Jesus told them, amen, you will see power and the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses. And then on that day, as they're sitting in the upper room praying, and then the evidence showed up as cloven tongues, like as of fire. Amen. God was beginning, amen, first of all, to cleanse them and get them ready for the ministry. Amen. But he had to burn up. Amen. The old order, he had to burn. He had to burn up the old school mentality. He had to burn up traditionalism. He had to burn up, amen, everything that was not like him. Amen. And when he got done with it, amen, the Bible says the cloven tongues fell like as a fire. Amen. The presence of God has always been, amen, assumed and has always been, amen, manifested through fire. Without fire, you don't know if God is there. But when the God shows up, the fire shows up. When God shows up, the burning shows up. When God shows up, cleansing takes place. When God shows up, healing takes place. There's something about the Holy Ghost. I can't explain it. But it's like fire.
I'm burning up the old, and I'm going to bring forth the new. Because if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Behold, all things have come to pass, and behold, now all things are new. Sometimes what God has to do is burn up all works in our life in order for the manifestation of the Holy Ghost to be seen in our life. He has given us the ability, but if we're so busy consumed by our own will, oh, he's not going to work for us.
that today we are in a mortgage burning service. Somebody is going to strike something, and it's going to produce a flame. And what I'm here to tell you today is, amen, don't let the fire go out. Keep the flame burning. Keep the flame burning. We burning the mortgage, but you got to keep the flame burning in your life. I want somebody to praise you. You got to keep your love for God burning in your life. You got to keep the love of God and the zeal of God burning in your life. Don't you let the enemy snuff out the flame of God. Thank you, Lord. Praise called Barak. Amen. Sometimes you gotta barak the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. That's when you get down on your knees. I always somebody with praise and walk in here. You're trying standing up and standing up. Amen. It's all right. But Lord, I need to breathe again. Amen. So you get down on your knees. Amen. And you begin to barak the Lord. That means to humble yourself. Amen, amen. So that, amen, as you begin to do that, you begin to increase the awareness of his presence in your life. I don't know about you, but I want to know that every day of my life, God is with me. Amen. I want to know that he walks with me. He talks with me. He tells me I am his own. And the joy that I share as we tarry there, none of us. Has ever known. I want to know that. I want to shabak you. Lord, come on here, somebody. I want to radically praise you. Amen. I want to give him a crazy praise. Amen. I want to give him a Yeah.
be seated in the presence of the Holy Ghost. But now, hallelujah, belongs to the Lord. Hallelujah, he's the one that delivered our souls. Thank you, Lord, he's the one that woke us up this morning. He's the one that kept us all day long. Thank you, Lord, he's the one that's going to watch over us all night long. But he that keepeth Israel, he never slumbers nor sleeps. Thank you, Lord, and we can depend on God. How many of you know you can depend on God? Through the storm, through the rain, through sickness, and through pain. You can depend on God. Come on, give your God a praise. Come on, God. If I had 10,000 tongues, I'd tell them all to praise him. Hallelujah, because he's worthy of all the praise. Thank you, Lord. And we just thank and praise the Lord. Amen. For all of you that are here today, come on, give God a praise. For this great mortgage burning celebration. Amen. Truly, if it had not been for the Lord, amen, who is on our side, thank you, Lord, there's no telling where we would be. And God is truly a good God. Isn't he a good God? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I praise God because I was, you know, you get caught up in things and you're moving around and you're trying to do things as a leader and whatever. Thank you, Lord. And then Sister Louise said to me, because I announced to the church, I said, you know, the church is going to be paid off and, you know, thinking about other things going through your mind. And she said, well, Pastor, we're going to have a mortgage burning celebration. I said, you know, you're right. Thank you, Lord. Yes, we're going to have a celebration. Amen. To celebrate what the Lord has done. Amen. All we ought to celebrate what God has done for us in our lives. Thank you, Lord. And we truly thank God. I thank God for my lovely wife, First Lady Tracy Quinn. Would y'all just stand with me? Just stand with me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. You know what I want to do? I want to have some church. Amen. I want to have church. Hallelujah. You know, you can't push it. You know, you got to wait for it to happen. Amen. It's like falling in love. You can't push falling in love. You gotta wait for it to happen. Amen. And I believe if you're picked with the Holy Ghost, let's stop talking about the Holy Ghost. He's a great God. So right now, thank you. Don't do that. pursuing excellence until excellence is achieved. Amen. This is excellent. Amen. A milestone. Amen. This is a blessing. Amen. In a short amount of time, I said, when I heard about it, I said, already?
For there the Lord commanded the blessings, even life, forevermore. May the Lord have blessing to his word.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Right now, we're going to turn into the hands of our praise team. Amen. Let's praise and worship service. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord, everybody. Come on, thank the Lord, everybody. Let me just say the celebration. Amen. Amen. We come to give God some praise today. Somebody say, I'm blessed. Come on, somebody say, I'm blessed. Hallelujah. Whoa.
Hallelujah!
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Brother Norman Gavin, come on, give God a praise.